sure if I can tune this in a little better. 108 miles an hour, something like that, as we go northbound here on I-75. They're advising Broward County now. They're getting on the radio and contacting Broward County to let them know that they've got a vehicle here. Also, they've contacted the Florida Highway Patrol. My understanding is that they're tracking this vehicle because it's got a device in it, one of those GPS trackers, and there's an agency that provides those to car owners, and apparently the owner of the car has this in it, and that information is being fed to the police departments around so that they know pretty much where the vehicle is and where it's headed. This is a helicopter here. Sky Force is up above them, just monitoring this activity. You see them make a light four-lane change there and try to hit the exit here. Joe, we're going to Miami Gardens Drive. Miami Gardens Drive from I-75. And we're going to... We picked up the westbound and whipping around in front of traffic that had just gotten the light to change there. Yeah, very, very dangerous there. So, Miami, he's going to be running out of real estate here. He can go south or north again. So we'll see, right? He's going to continue westbound. Yeah, where he's going, it's a dead end. So I don't know if there are any ground units that are going to be following him right now. We have two units behind him now. You'll see them come into frame here. I'm going to stay a little bit wider. Maybe we'll see, but he's in the parking area here. This is that mass transit, one of those mass transit facilities. Oh, you got the other chopper there, right, Joe? Okay. Yeah, we're going to wait for him. No way to exit, according to the police chopper, saying that there's okay, now, there, if you look on the left-hand side of the screen, you're going to see police officers, three cars there, four cars, five cars coming in here. And he's going to... police are coming into the parking lot. He jumped over the curb. Now it looks like he might be able to get back out. Yeah, he's back out. And there they are. They're right behind him. You can see the police officers. They're down through the grass, through the median, back eastbound on 183rd. And he's going to be coming up to I-75. So we do have ground units in the area. And slower traffic now. You can see there's the police officers there. A wrong way on I-75. He's going to be on the on-ramp. I-75, it looks like he's going the wrong way. So this is very, very dangerous situation now. Let's see if we can stay with it. And again, we want to caution everybody here that he's losing a little bit of traction there. He may have cut a tire. Maybe that'll slow him down a little. But he is on I-75 going the wrong direction. You can see vehicles there going by him now. And he's going underneath an overpass there. Hang on a second. We'll reacquire. There he is right there. When you can, Joe, if we can, we need to get on the other side of that thing. I'm going to zoom out so I don't lose him too much. All right, but he's coming out from underneath the flyover. Oncoming traffic, heading toward oncoming traffic. Tractor trailer there you see go zooming by. And, this is a very dangerous situation here. I can't find another way to express it. It's just the kind of thing that you just hope you don't see. But it's happening here live right now as this vehicle... just very dangerous. Let me look ahead here and just see if there's anybody coming right now. That's the HOV. They're telling everybody to stop pursuing the vehicle. There goes a trooper through the going the other way. There are no police vehicles right now on that roadway. According to the aviation unit, the helicopter from the Miami-Dade Police Department, there are no police officers going the wrong way on I-75 right now. We bring the camera back out here real quick. You can see that they are not on that roadway. They are not pursuing them that way. They may be paralleling him in the correct lanes of traffic in the correct direction, but that's what we're hearing. Now look at that. Imagine yourself driving north southbound on this roadway, conducting your normal business, and there's a vehicle headed right towards you. It would just be just a staggering thing to try to deal with. So the vehicle continues northbound. I want to say we're coming up on, let's see here. We're coming up to Pines. We're coming up to Pines and, right. Just past Miramar Parkway, coming up to Pembroke Road. This would be a Pembroke Road, and again, northbound in the southbound lane, slowing down. Now he's going to make a U-turn. He's made a U-turn. Now he's turning and going southbound. Now he's back in the right lanes of traffic, and he's going to be heading back on southbound I-75. Incredible turns and movements here by this vehicle. Police have been trying to follow the vehicle safely and get it to stop. So far, unsuccessful in doing that, but successful in keeping everybody safe so far. This vehicle, again, wanted, the driver wanted for some felony issues and also because of a stolen vehicle. We saw the police, where'd he go? I think he stopped underneath the overpass. Oh, there he is. Okay, sorry about that. I was looking out my window, trying to acquire with my eyes out the window, and I lost the vehicle there for a second. But again, the vehicle southbound, I-75, after going northbound in the wrong lanes of travel, and the police helicopter from Miami-Dade continues to track this. They've notified Broward County, Broward Sheriff's Office of this issue, and they're aware. They were waiting up in Broward County. Now we've got the Florida Highway Patrol also monitoring the situation. He says it's going to stay on I-75 back toward Miami Lakes. There it goes zipping out of that Miami Gardens Drive right there, we're being told, and it continues to go southbound. So an exhaustive chase here that's lasted now the better part of, I want to say, 25 or 30 minutes since we've been up anyway. And hearing some other traffic on here, just trying to decipher exactly what they're referencing here, but it appears right now that the helicopter is going to be the only asset that the police department has that's going to be involved in following this, although the ground units are being advised of its location and direction of travel. Okay, I'm told right now if I zoom out, there you go, right there, you can see the police helicopter go right through the shot there. We'll keep it a little wider here for a second so we have that shot for you. But you can see he's paralleling that vehicle and relaying by radio that information to the ground unit so they do know where this vehicle is headed, and they're going to just continue to monitor. But one of two things usually happens: they either run out of gas, or three things: they run out of fuel, they have an accident of some sort, or they stop and bail out and go out on foot and try to escape. Yes. I'm not hearing the people back at this studio right now. I don't know if they're there or not, but again, we continue to follow this vehicle. Yeah, okay. We continue to follow the vehicle southbound on I-75 with monitoring the police radios here as we do normally. I see a jet up there. You got that jet jump? Okay. Reckless driving and felony fleeing. That's what they're mentioning on the radio right now, the specifics of exactly what's occurring here. So we're going to just continue to monitor. You see damage to that vehicle, but apparently right now the tires are all in good condition. It continues to go southbound as our police monitor the activities of the driver, and I believe there may be a second person in that vehicle, and then that person's involvement in it, except that they're sitting in the passenger seat right now. So that's the information that police has developed so far. We're going. Yep. Yep. Highway Patrol is coming up behind him, I'm being told, by our pilot, Joe Mancino, so we'll widen the camera back out. They're just getting ready to go. That's 107th Avenue there. You see the Florida Highway Patrol vehicle at the lower right-hand corner of your screen closing in right now. We're coming up to the Palmetto Expressway on what is the exit of I-75 there, and becomes the Gratney. You know, it looks like it's going to be southbound on the Palmetto Expressway. Yeah, you can see a radical move there. Then it's going to go around to the breakdown lane around these slower vehicles, and when I say slower, they're probably onto the Palmetto Expressway southbound. We're keeping the camera slightly wider here because we're just, I don't want to lose that vehicle again as he zips around. But again, traveling much faster than the normal traffic in this area, but being pursued now by Florida Highway Patrol. Bring the camera back out and see if the FH2 vehicle is going to be in counter range as he zips around again. You see those moves that he's making. Passing 103rd Street, passing 103rd Street southbound. The black Mazda compact vehicle that was wanted for being stolen. First of all, it's recognized as being stolen, and they ran the information about the person that they believe stole the vehicle. It came back with felony issues, is the term that the police department's been using. Following this vehicle right now is a Florida Highway Patrol cruiser that was traveling at an equal speed there for a while. It's out of our camera view right now. And also we have the Miami-Dade, one of Miami-Dade Police Aviation units, one of their helicopters down below is tracking this vehicle. We showed you that video a short time ago, pictures of that. There's another FHT car that just got past there. And you can see it just continues to move at an extremely high rate of speed there. Southbound on the Palmetto Expressway coming up to Okeechobee Road, the Okeechobee Road exit here, zipping around, making lane changes here, left and right, as it continues to move southbound on the Palmetto Expressway.